effect on everybody in St. John that's going to be watching this or hearing this or reading about this. You know, how this student and many other students are urging everybody in St. John to become organ donors. It's a way of getting to everybody's hearts and minds.
And you're mentioning that people shouldn't have to wait for transplants?
No, we shouldn't have to wait for this. We should be able to.
I had
receive an organ transplant, and that is very possible, and that's our ultimate goal. It might not be around the corner, but I know if we keep at this and we keep getting students involved, the community involved, the media involved, that we'll get there.
Why are you getting there?
Well, I think there's a lack of political will right now. We can do a lot more with our governments in this, and we need to understand that this issue needs to have the same profile as any of the other leading issues, and that if we can get to that status, we'll be able to solve it, because our remedy to this isn't to look for a cure in a laboratory. Our remedy is to reach everybody so everybody can become an organ donor. If we reach that, then we have the problem solved. So it's a very simple problem to solve. It's just difficult to proceed with.
How many people are waiting?
Presently, there's over 4,000 Canadians that are waiting in Canada, and that's a combination of men, women, and children.
And they die waiting.
Almost every day, somebody's dying on that waiting list, waiting. And when you're told you're on the waiting list, that's the good news. The bad news is that because Canada has one of the lowest rates, you're waiting desperately. Radio, and we have some other counties there today, and everybody else here. So he's a very nice guy.
Yeah.
What time is it?
It is 12:40.
Oh no, this is their room now. You're
giving them an extension.
So what's going on today, Julie?
Well, today, as you can see, Chris. There's a lot of media here, and there's a lot of, you can feel the energy.
I can.
I can too. And it's, you know.
I was just shocked when you were doing that interview, like six people came out to the cameras. Like,
yeah, it's just crazy. It feels like old times.
It does.
You know? And, so today's special day because, remember, we're doing it in the memory of Rachel Jane.
Yep.
And, you know, the family's here, and this is what it's really all about, Chris.
Good. This is what we're
talk to the office. All right.
Thank you.
what's going to happen. How are you? Yes, right. Oh, sorry. No, I think it's a check. Or you can contact my student house and they can get you there. I think it's something that people don't think about. People don't like to think about like nasty things, but it's something really important. Really, really that I saved so many people's lives. Like a couple of years ago, only 14 out of a million people were actually injured during war.
Do you think there are misconceptions?
Chris.